for the recording, can I just get your name again?
I'm Linda Cooper.
And we're interviewing you here at the White Hart in Caldmore on the... What's the date?
It's the 29th, isn't it?
Very well. 28th of September, 2022. Are you happy for me to use... To disseminate your testimony to go forward with it?
I'll stand by mine, what I know, yeah.
Would you be happy for me to use bits of the recording as well?
Yes, I wouldn't. If you want to, I don't mind.
Would you very kindly tell me about the grey lady that you were speaking of with the White Hart?
As far as I was aware, she was a teenage servant from when it was the house, not when it had been moved on to become the coaching inn or the pub, but she was actually got pregnant, so to speak, by one of the landed gentry. And because they didn't want anything like that happening, they took the child away from the mother. The mother was so distraught, she apparently hanged herself up in the room. And she's supposed to be the grey lady that walks. And a lot of people have said, when they've been going up and down the Corporation Street, that they've seen faces at the window. Now, I've never seen the face at the window, but Aldridge Fire Crew will bear witness to it. They came to put the fire out, they checked the building, they knew it was okay, they drove round, looked up, just as you do, and there was a face at the window, and they thought maybe some twitter had got in. So they went back to have another check, checked it all round, nothing. And they did the same check twice, and they could still see the face at the window. Now the face that always appears over the archway. Maybe it's a bathroom now. But one young man who was going to see his girlfriend, I saw him and he goes, "You didn't wave to me," and I waved to you. And apparently he'd seen the face as he was running down the hill. He said, "But he looked like you." And I used to have long hair. And I said, "Well," I said, "I don't have an upstairs. How can it be me? My window's face forward." He said, "Well, it looked like you, Linda," but he didn't do the journey again, frightened him to death. And apparently the young woman presumed her child would be murdered, I suppose. But many years later, when this man came to see me, and he said he was descended from the baby that was put up at Rock Cottage, which was in Sandhill Street. And he backtracked it. He said that 7 generations.
So he thinks he was the descendant of that baby. Very interesting. So
that's beautiful.
Does the grey lady then in any way relate to the hand?
To be honest, nobody really knows. All we know is we know what it's not. Let's say it's not. I know it's classed as a hand of glory. Well, it can't be, because a hand of glory is usually what they chop off the wrist off of a hanged felon, and then it's either covered with gas, and then it's lit, and then they break into places, and then the smoke that comes off the hand is of the wax, not people out. So any would-be burglars who come in, burgle it and be on the way before anybody recovered. But that's a hand of glory. This is a child's arm. And apparently it was vivisected from the shoulder. And I think it's the left hand, because it's this darling little hand. It's only about that long. But nobody can find any suitable answers as to what it's for and why it was here.
Do you know when and where it was found?
It was found in the second chimney upstairs when they were renovating it.
Do you know what year that was?
Well, I was under the impression it was when they were changing it from the actual hall as it was then, into the, when it became a coaching inn. And we were under the impression it was that period. And then after it was the coaching inn, it became the pub. And then after that, it was like derelict. And I always presume it. Well, I presume it's about 200, 300 years old. I mean, I know it's built in 1534.
Did anyone ever see a ghost of a small child?
Now, it's weird you should say that, because the answer to that is yes. And it's a little girl. And my partner, who was sitting more or less while I'm sitting there, he's been to the pub, and he came in, and he was sitting, and I said, "What are you doing?" I'm talking to this little girl, and I thought he'd gone daft, actually. And apparently he described her. Apparently her name was Martha. She'd got a little brother with her, who was sort of standing over there, and his name was Zachariah. And now, I've never had any contact with actually physically with children, but you are well aware that there are children about. And I've had friends come that have got children, and one little boy played sitting over there for a long time. And so, are you warm enough, James? And he said, yes, auntie, I'm playing with a little boy. Now, I couldn't see a boy, but this little child could see a boy. And when my friend was sitting chatting to him, he said, do you like that? He said, he starts there again. And he said, yes, will the lady with the little boy be there? And she said, no, James, Linda doesn't have a little boy. He said, oh, I didn't mean Linda, I meant the other lady with the little boy. So he could obviously see. And we've had people that have frightened the death of the place. We've had my friend's son used to come and lie up here to see how brave he was. And I always used to read him a story, so it'd be about anything from 10, 11, 12, 13 upwards. And he said he went to shout boo and frighten me to death because he thought I was leaning over and Chetty was asleep, so I had to go to bed. He said his own little cat, which he'd brought with him, was rubbing his head up something, but he was that frightened, he never came again. And he swears by it, he doesn't believe in ghosts, but if something put the wind up him down, and he was hammering on my door, Linda, 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 Linda. Whatever's the matter, David? He said, there's a ghost, David, this is the White Hart, everybody knows the place is haunted, I've told you enough times. But people get different sensations. When I first came, I got my hair pulled. I got the sensation of somebody trying to resuscitate me. And I was so frightened, I wouldn't sleep in my bedroom. But my friend, who talks to this little girl, and he said, he described her, and apparently she might have been a child of the house, not the pub or the coach inn, due to the state of her clothes. She'd got little silk slippers on, and she'd got long curly hair. And she was chatting, and he was holding his hand out, and he says, her hand's in my hand, I can see it. But he reads palms, so whether that makes any difference. And my daughter and my fella are the only two people that they cannot walk down the hall without getting pushed into the wall. And I mean, my fella's off, he's 23 stone, he's a big boy to be being pushed anyway. And he went bang, straight up his nose. But after I saw this old man, and I thought, well, in for the penny. So I said, now, I don't know whether you can hear me. I'm not even sure I'm not going to lost the plot altogether. But, grey lady, if you can hear me, I need you to know that your baby didn't die. And that the man that came was your descendant. And I'm really sorry that you were sad and you had to hang yourself. But honestly, your baby survived and we've had no more problems since.
Amazing.
Not at all.
You said previously that there was a Cromwellian sword found at the same time as the arm.
Yeah.
And what did you say had happened to it when?
The builders that were renovating the place obviously thought it was a good idea and they took it. We presume it was stolen because it vanished, but they obviously didn't want the arm. I'm the only one that actually wants the arm. I think he thought to be in the White Hart.
Were you ever aware of a secret passage in the cellar?
Oh yes, we were told about the cellars because what they were passages of escape. So, and as far as we know, they came from here up as far as St. Michael's Church. There was talk that they went as far as St. Matthew's or the other ones that went that way and came up at High Bullen. I think it's St. Matthias or St. Bartholomew, something like that. But apparently, so Karmahausen, who used to own it, told me that they'd sealed the cellars because apparently there were two soldiers trying to escape and they were found by Cromwell's men and they were killed in the statue, killed in the cellars and they were walled in. So whether they were actually haunted for more than one ghost, I really don't know. But this grey lady paranormal society said usually it's normal for the temperature to drop. He says, but yours is going down, and then it's coming up, and then it's coming down. And he says, if I were you, I would move your furniture around and not let anybody sit at the corner, because they'd have to get very cold. And that's the corner. I just thought I'd mention it.
Thank you very much.